Welcome to this session on how to create tests in manual mode. In this session, we are going to learn what is manual mode, how can we create our test in manual mode, and how can we edit our test. We will also look at some useful tips towards the end of this session. Let's get started. What is manual mode? Let me go to our Katalon Studio, and before we start creating our test, let us understand what is manual mode. So in Katalon Studio, we have already seen that we have three modes of test case creation. First mode is record and replay that we have already seen in our earlier sessions. And then we have a manual mode and we have a script mode. So in manual mode, a user can create a test by manually adding the steps and adding actions and keywords. We will look exactly how to do that in this session. So now we have to create our test in manual mode. What exactly we are going to automate is this scenario where we will go to this particular URL, which is a demo site for Orange HRM. Let us go here. This is the URL. I will make this URL available in the description of the video as well. And here we will do a login. We will do some add some checkpoints and then we will exit. Okay. So for automating this test, what exactly we are going to do is we are going to do three basic steps. Step one is we will capture all the objects to be used in the test. So let us do that. Let us go to our Katalon Studio and let us go to spy web. This is the spy web icon. I'm going here, and here I can start with a URL and then start capturing my objects. So I will enter this URL. Let me copy it from here and I will add it here and I will say start. You can select any of these browsers. Let me select Chrome here. And you can see this browser has come. And now I can hover over any object or any element and then I can press Alt plus twiddle key on my keyboard and the object will be captured, and you can see that object here in the captured object. So let us do that. The first thing is we have to capture this username text box. So I will go here and press Alt plus twiddle key, and you can see it has come here in the captured objects. Then I will go to this password text box. I will press Alt plus twiddle key and then login button. And now I have to go to the next page. So I will actually log in. And in this on this site, you have all these username and passwords. You can use any of these username and passwords. I'm using the admin. I'll click login here. And now I am on the home page. Here I just want to validate this text or this object, welcome admin. So I will again press Alt plus twiddle key. And then I want to click on this timesheets. So again, I will press Alt plus twiddle key. And I'll now close my browser, and you can see all these objects have been captured. Now we can click on this add objects to repository button. So I'll click here and all these objects have come here. You can check or uncheck any object if you do not want to add it. And now you can add it to the default object repository or you can create a new folder. It is always suggested that you create a new folder so that you know this is a separate test case, and I will create it as a folder name test_2_OR. OR is the abbreviation for object repository, and test2 is the test that I'm going to create. So in future, I will know that this object repository is for test2. I will click OK and OK. And if I close this window, you can see inside the object repository, I have test2._OR folder and I have all my objects here. Now there are other ways as well to capture objects. If you are on Chrome, you can right click and do inspect, and it will go give you the text, username and other things, and you can capture objects with these IDs. You can go to Firefox and again you can do a right click inspect element, or you can use plugins like Firebug, which are available for Firefox, and it will help you identifying the objects like this. Or if you are on Safari, again you can do the same thing. You can do right click and inspect element. So right click and inspect element. In case you do not get inspect element in Safari, you can go to the Safari preferences and advanced, and make sure you have this show develop menu in menu bar checked, and then you will get the inspect element. So there are different ways of capturing objects. The straightforward way that Katalon Studio provides us is the spy web, so we have used that straightforward options. And now we have to create our test in manual mode. So let us do that. I'm going to my Katalon Studio and I'm going to new test case, and here I will give test case name as test underscore 2. We have already created test underscore 1 in our earlier sessions while we were demoing record and replay. So I will create test underscore 2 and say OK. And it has created the test, and then we have to run the test. But before that, we have to actually create our steps. So you can see, if you go down, this is the manual mode. So it by default opens in the manual mode. You can change these in the preferences as well. But now we have to start creating our test case. So for that, once you are in manual mode, you can go to add and you can add any of these keywords. I will say web UI keyword, and here you can start typing. So I want to open browser. I will say start typing open browser, and it has given me the option. It also shows me all the information about this keyword, and if you click on this I icon, it will take you to the documentation for this keyword. So for now, I'll just click here open browser, and there's no object, but for input I have to give the URL. I can keep it optional and then I can use another keyword as navigate and then give the URL, but I will give it here as well. So let me just go to this URL, copy this URL from here, and I will give it inside here and say OK. OK. So I have opened the browser and I have gone to this URL. The next thing is I have to do a login, right? So now I will add another keyword, which will be set text. So I have got this set text, and here I have to add an object. So I can go to here, object repository, and I have to add this object input txt password. So I can double click here. It gives me the options. I can go here and say select this, and in the input I will give the username admin. Okay, and then the next action is again I have to add a password. Now another good thing in Katalon Studio is you can go to this keywords icon, this keyword browser, click here, and you will get all the built-in keywords. Go here, and I want to add a keyword for web UI. Inside this category I am going to text, and I have got a set text here, right? So you can browse keywords like that. Also you can drag and drop it directly in the manual mode. So it has come here, and again I have to add the object, which is this one. I think we made a mistake. This object is username, which is this one, and now we will have password. So again you can drag and drop this object as well in the manual mode, and then add the password. So we have done that. Then we have to click on the login button. So again you can do add, click object, I will drag and drop, and that's it. And then we have to add a checkpoint. So let us add verify text present, and I will just say this is text should be welcome admin. So this is our checkpoint. And then again let us click on an image. So I will say click and add this particular image, and then at the end I will add a close browser step. So close browser. So our test is ready. Okay, now we have to run our test. So I will just save it. I will go to run, and I have created on I have captured the objects on Chrome, so let us run it on Firefox. So this is launching the test case. It will open a Firefox browser and let us see if it runs our manually created test case or not. Yes, it is running the Firefox browser now. It will open the browser. This browser is open. It's going to the URL. Yes, it is doing all the actions and it has closed the browser and our test is done. Let us go to the log viewer and see all our steps passed. We can get all the information here by filtering from this menu and everything is passed. So we have created our test in manual mode and also executed it. Now suppose you have created your test case, but you now need to edit or do some more actions. So again, we have this menu options here, this toolbar. We can add any of these actions or keywords right from here. You can delete, move up and down. And then we have already seen how do we add or update objects and then the inputs and other things. So this is very intuitive and very easy in the manual mode. Let us look at some useful tips. How to proceed on failure. So for example, your test step fails. What will happen after that? Let us go to our Katalon Studio and I'm going to my step number 5 and I will deliberately fail this step. Let me go here and let me change this text to welcome admins and this should fail this step because it will not find this particular text. Let me save it and run it again. So I have deliberately edited my text so that the step should fail and we want to see what exactly happens if there is any failure inside a test case. So it is opening my Firefox browser now. And let us wait for the test to get completed. So it is going to the login screen. We'll enter the username, password, click on login. And let us see what happens now. Okay, so see it even did not close the browser, which was our next step. And if I go back to my Katalon Studio and I go to the log viewer, you can see this all failed. Okay, and then the test case did not proceed after the failure. So how to handle this? What we can do is you can go to your project settings and then go to the test case. So I'm going to my Katalon Studio project menu and then I'm going to settings and here if you go to the test case option you have this default failure handling for test step and here we have these three options. Okay, so we have these three options. Let us see what all this means. Stop on failure is by default selected. I will select continue on failure and let us see what happens now. I will say okay and now let us run our test case once again and let us see what happens now. So it is launching the test case. It's opening the Firefox browser now. And yes, let us watch what happens now. The username, password, click on login button. And yes, the test is done. Let us go to our log viewer and you can see this step failed, but it did not stop. It went to the next step and it went to the next step. And then finally it said the test case is failed because one of the steps failed. Okay, so this is how you can proceed on failure. Now there is another thing that you might want, that even if the test fails, a step fails, the step is optional, so it should not be displayed as a failure. So for that, again, you can go to your project settings and this time we will say, we will go to test case and we will say optional. So this makes it optional, so it will not show as a failure. I will say okay and save our test case and run it again, and let us see what happens now. It's launching the test case. It's opening the browser now. And let us wait for the test case to get completed, and we will see the results after that. And yes, the test got completed, and now you can see in the log viewer, the failed step is just shown as a warning, and even the test case is now considered as passed. It is not considered as failed. Okay, so this is what we can do. We have all these three options, and you can go to the Katalon Studio website, go to documentation and user guide. Inside, go to create automation test, and we have this failure handling. If you go here, they have explained in detail all these three steps. Okay, what does stop on failure, continue on failure, and what does optional means. Okay, so this is how we can do it. One more tip is how you can set these options per step. So this is something you will need, right? You do not want all the steps to have a default behavior. You want that verify text present should be optional, but others should not be. So what you can do is you can go to that step, do a right click, and then set it from here. Change failure handling. So this is optional, but yes, this is not optional. So if I right click here, I can say this is stop on failure. So you can also see these icons get changed accordingly. So this is how you can set the proceed on failure options. Let us do a very quick recap. In this session, we learned what is manual mode, how do we create test in manual mode, how we can edit and update, and other features of the manual mode, and we also looked at some useful tips. In the next session, we are going to start with our script mode, and we will see exactly how do we use our script mode in Katalon Studio.